If I ever took a loss, I learned a lesson. I won't ever think I'm better than the next man. I've been down before to come up, I ain't stressing. Baby, I'm too busy counting all these blessings. Yes, yes.
Canada, Canada, Canada. Latima, Latima, Latima. Sweat the sun shining on me, get my heart up. No matter the trouble surrounding us, they don't see that it's a lot of us. Everybody move anonymous. Won't take that credit, I know what we get it. Them blessings be coming from God above. I was doing all kind of bad, what a quiet.
What's up, guys? I just woke up, as you can probably tell. It's Thursday, August 13th. It's about 9:20 in the morning. Something I forgot to say in the last video. Like I said, I live in Topeka, Kansas, but I'm currently staying in Atlanta, Georgia with my uncle for about 3 weeks. I've been here for about two, have about one week left. So today I'm gonna go, there's a place about 30 minutes north of here that I'm going to train. Found this place about a week ago. Really like the coach, really like the facility. So we're going there. I'm not sure how it's gonna work in terms of filming the practice, but I'll do what I can and let you guys know how it goes.
Yeah, it's just something like I looked at my life and I looked at my wife.
All right, so we just got here. Here's the facility. There's the coach in the back. We're gonna warm up now.
Right, look, I'm not switching my price. Baby, I know what I'm worth. I be like, they got it Monday. I get to get back to work. Hey, sound like gold. They don't want story, man, they want the sound bite. I'm like, no, look around like they see you on the mound, they don't see you on the climb. Right, me and all of mine in the power line. Look at this and what you find. Right,
shimmer, life, flicker, all this life. Let it shimmer. I had a glow up. Show up. I got the light now.
Remember, as soon as you stop moving the top hand, make it fast enough to where you catch up to your body so you don't exhale and fly out, right?
Yeah, I felt it on that one.
Yeah. Sure. Overall, I mean, jumps are 13 ticks bungee. I mean, I can measure it for sure to find out, but I like where this is going. We found you the right hold. So, any feedback on what you're feeling? Like, feel good, bad?
I mean, it felt good. The run's definitely feeling good. For that one, I felt myself get to here and then I just let off.
Give me that close that 6 inches of gap, and then while you're doing this, drop your shoulder. Mm-hmm. Get your shoulders back while you're moving your hand, and then you're set up like a corkscrew spring on top of the pole. You turn, you get thrown over the bucket. That's the last step. But that's the hardest thing to do when you're on a bigger pole, higher grip, and trying to make things work. You know, in your face. It's simple.
Yeah.
Biggest thing I've learned, if you start focusing on the height of what you're jumping versus what you're actually like trying to execute, you just completely throw technique out the window. I used to do that too. Make sense? All right, I'll go ahead and make all the adjustments. So all you need to focus on is executing and jumping. All right.
You cleared the bungee too.
Yeah, I'm gonna set the bar to the next height and you're not gonna know what it is. Let's just do the exact same thing. Holy crap, that was awesome.
So good.
This is why I do what I do.
Why?
because it's the joy of putting the pieces together of like me when I was a vaulter, I didn't really have this kind of coaching. So I'd sit here and struggle and bang my head on the pole. And I'm like, I'm trying to figure out how to jump higher. And I want to be that next puzzle piece for Mike or anyone else in the country. That Mike. I gotta say, you're pretty ecstatic about what you're doing right now. And it's like, this isn't complicated. Why my philosophy in pole vaulting is I give simple solutions to a complex sport. And nothing that we've done has been complicated, right? Literally, we've just adjusted how you take off, what you do when you're at the takeoff, and how you finish over the bar. And you PR by 4 inches without knowing it was a 4-inch PR. All right, I'm gonna adjust the bar height to the exact same thing. Versus horizontal.
Yeah, I felt on the way up.
And the pole feel like it's gonna work, right?
Yeah.
Standard's in the right spot. You just need to move back 3 inches on the runway.
Yeah.
You missed the jump. You missed the takeoff, and you knocked the bar off. That's a hat trick right there. Long and aggressive, I didn't mean over exaggerate.
Yeah, I'm done.
Yeah, you're done.
You had a gas.
Yeah. It's all work today. That just means you gotta jump those PR meet, right?
Alright, we just finished practice. As the coach, what are your thoughts on the day?
Overall, good improvement. Definitely, I think you're mentally stronger than when you came here. And to run down there and jump a PR of 12.5 on the first attempt, I mean, as a coach, you can't ask anything better than that. And then how do you feel about like the surprise of not knowing what the height of the bar was when you jumped it?
Definitely felt good. I wasn't even thinking about the crossbar.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a little more satisfying when you trust the coach and his decision or her decision to actually make a move for you, and then you execute as an athlete.
Yeah, definitely felt good.
Good.
So jumping a PR on Saturday at the meet.
That's the plan. Good? Yes.
All right, so we're leaving practice now. I jumped a 4-inch PR today in practice on a bar. Like I said, pole vault isn't all good. There was, you know, positives and negatives to the practice. You'll see that. You'll see the bad jumps, and you'll see the good one. Overall, pretty successful day, and hope that it translates to the meet on Saturday. So.